Namaste. Tomorrow we are going to celebrate the very auspicious festival, auspicious Vedic festival, Ugadi. Now, Ugadi is more than just another festival. It is a very powerful muhurtam which has a significant astrological influence. And in this video, I'll share the astrological influence that exists on this day, and I will also share my astrological analysis of the chart that is casted for Ugadi. Now, Ugadi starts on March 24th, roughly at around 2-6 p.m. Indian Standard Time. So, for all practical purposes, instead of worrying about when to observe Ugadi, whether to do it 24th or whether to do it on 25th, you can comfortably observe it on 25th, because this beginning of Ugadi, that is the Pratama, Chaitra Masa Shukla Paksha Pratama, this beginning of Ugadi starts after noon. So you can observe this on March 25th. Now, I told you that there's a very powerful significance behind this. So what is the science behind Ugadi, and what is the significance behind Ugadi? We all know that the earth moves around the sun, and when it does the revolution, when it does, it doesn't move in a circular orbit, it moves in an elliptical orbit. We also know that sun is not in the center of this orbit, but it is there in one of the focal points. So what happens is, at any point of time, the distance between the sun and the moon will not be uniform. Sometimes it will be very far away, or sometimes it will be close, depending on which position it takes. When the earth is far away, farthest away from the sun, it is known as apihelix. And when it is closer to the sun, it is known as perihelix. Now, what happens during Ugadi is, it is neither far nor closer to sun. It is equidistant. It is essentially the distance between the sun and the earth is at its average point. So, the rays of the sun that is received by the earth will be very uniform in nature. That's number one. Number two, in most parts of the world, majority parts of the world, especially the regions between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, you will notice that the length of the day and the length of the night will be the same. Roughly 12 hours, plus or minus 15 degrees as it moves upwards or downwards. But you will notice, by and large, the length of the day and length of the night will be same. Sama. Because of this, the light that we receive from the sun will be very calibrated and very equalized. The third thing that happens on this day is, we all know that the earth is tilted, right? It is not straight, but it is tilted around its axis. Now, what happens is, because it is tilted around its axis, if you imagine that there is a line that we can draw, or a plane that can originate, start from the center of the earth and extend along the equatorial plane to the space. So if we have one orbital plane that starts from the equatorial plane of the earth, and similarly if we do a similar plane that starts from the center of the sun and extends, we will have two orbital planes. Now, because the earth is tilted around its axis, these two orbital planes are never aligned with each other. It's tilted. And during different parts of the year, this tilt keeps changing. Now, what happens is, on the day of Ugadi, these orbital planes exactly align with each other. So essentially, when you draw a line between the center of the earth and center of the sun, these planes, they actually coincide with that line. So there are three things that is happening. One is the distance between the sun and the earth is neither too far nor too close. It is perfect. The length and the of the day and the night, the length of the day and the night, they are almost equal. And third one is the equatorial plane of the earth and of the sun, they are in perfect alignment. This is known as the supreme alignment. So Ugadi usually is considered, when you look at the word Ugadi, Yuj and Adi means, Yuj means union and Adi means first. So usually because it happens in the Chaitra Paksha Shukla Pratama, it is usually known as the first union of the sun and the moon. But it's not just that. Because of these three things that happen, it's actually the union of the of not just sun and the moon, but it's the union of the sun and the earth. And that's why Ugadi in its real translation means, Yug means union and Adi means supreme, foremost. So this is like the foremost union that you can get. Now because this is a foremost union, this is extremely good for us. Look at this as a muhurta, and this muhurta is 24 hours long muhurta, and you can undertake any auspicious work during this part of the day. What type of work that you could do? You can look at spiritual progress, you can look at material progress, you can also look at the mental progress and the physical progress. All these type of progress can be initiated on the day of Ugadi. Now, for 2020, when you cast a chart at the time of the commencement of Ugadi, it paints a very unique picture. Let me give you my interpretation, my astrological analysis of the Ugadi chart, 2020 chart, for you. I mentioned this earlier, but from a hygiene perspective, this year, this Samvatsara is known as Sharvari. Now, Sharvari in classical scriptures is considered to be a very auspicious Samvatsara, which essentially, the description that we get in these classical scriptures is that Sharvari is usually associated with plenty of rainfall. So it is actually very good for farmers. They will have a good crop. Also, this is the best time for innovation. So any businesses that are there or any individuals who would like to do a lot of innovative work, this is the best year for them to get started. So that, you know, they realize their ambitions. Now, if we cast a horoscope at the commencement of Ugadi, what we see is the lagnam that is rising is Kataka or Cancer at 9 degrees 35 minutes. And interestingly, the nakshatra is Pushyami. Now, Pushyami is a very auspicious nakshatra. Why is it? Because while the ruler of Pushyami is Saturn, Jupiter, which is also known as Jiva, it becomes exalted in this nakshatra. So it is becoming highly auspicious in the nakshatra of Pushyami. Jupiter shines with exuberance. It is in its most blissful state, most beneficial state. So anything that you ask to Jupiter is going to be blessed by him. But then, let's not just conclude on these things. I want to draw your attention to four interesting placements of planets. The first one is the placement of the Lagna Lord. As I told you, Kataka is the rising sign and the Lord of Kataka is Moon, and he is placed in the ninth house. And he is not alone. Because it's Ugadi, because it's Pratama, he is in close distance with the sun. So essentially the Lord of the Ascendant and the Lord of the Second are in conjunction in the ninth house, which is very good. Now, what also happens is three planets are also viewing the Lagna: Saturn, Jupiter, and Mars. Now Saturn, as the 7th and the 8th lord, is placed in the 7th house, aspecting the Lagna. So while Saturn is a first rate malefic, for this horoscope, he becomes a functional benefic. And he is sitting in his own house, so which makes him very favorable, 75% favorable. Jupiter is a natural benefic, but for this horoscope, he becomes the 6th lord and the 9th lord. So he becomes a first rate malefic, and he is in Nicha Sthana, that is evil position, in Capricorn. So this cannot be ignored. The Yoga Karaka Mars, why Yoga Karaka? Because he is the 5th lord and the 10th lord. He is placed in the 6th house, aspecting the Lagna and giving an 8th aspect. So what does it mean? Just Mars alone will bring in a very competitive spirit and a very fighting spirit. Now this combination of Mars influencing the Lagna, Saturn influencing the Lagna, Jupiter influencing the Lagna has both good and bad effects. I foresee an atmosphere where people will be largely fighting amongst themselves and anger will prevail. Because of the position of Jupiter in an inauspicious situation, people at large, the common public at large, will be misguided by people who are taking advisory roles. So these could be judges, these could be doctors, these could be counselors, these could even be politicians. There will also be a lot of fight that might result in loss of life, bloodbath, and destruction of property. The combination of Jupiter and Saturn is the reason. There's a strong undercurrent that makes people get irritated, short-tempered, and also grouchy. Anger will prevail for no reason. The aspect of Mars will increase the fighting and competitive spirit. The weak position of Saturn, even though he is in an auspicious sign in his own house, because his sign is under the threat of Jupiter, there will be a lot of irritation and short-temperedness as an undercurrent overall. On the other hand, this is a great time for doing a spiritual activities. So sadhana, if anybody is interested to do sadhana, this is a great time. Specifically, what I would want to share is there are two types of spiritual practices that every one of us should be doing during this year of Sharvari. There, one is Mauna Vratam and the second one is Kumbhaka Pranayama. Now Mauna Vratam is very commonly observed by all the sages, all the rishis. So in the current modern times, it is very difficult to observe Mauna Vratam. So try to limit the amount of communication that you do. Now, I've used the word communication. The reason why I've used the word communication is because Mauna Vratam doesn't mean not talking. So usually people, when they observe Mauna Vratam, they don't talk, but they do every possible communication, like, you know, signaling, making noise, writing, and all those things. None of these things should be done. Mauna Vrata in its truest form means shut down from all sorts of communication. So essentially, look inwards. So ideally, isolate yourself for good amount of time. Look inwards. Try to at least do this about 15 minutes per day or 30 minutes per day, based on whatever your convenience is. Try to shut down all sorts of communication. No WhatsApp, no social media, no signs, no signals, no listening to music, nothing. Just look inwards, just sit still, look inwards. This is one of the greatest practices for spiritual sadhana, given the current planetary positions. The second one is Kumbhaka Pranayama. Now there are many variations of Pranayama, but Kumbhaka Pranayama will be very, very good to activate the spiritual rise in oneself. So if you want to activate and tap the power of Kundalini Shakti, doing Kumbhaka Pranayama during this year is extremely beneficial for you. So Kumbhaka Pranayama essentially would mean that you inhale and before you exhale, you retain the breath for a brief amount of time. So you can retain this for whatever is comfortable for you, but the longer that you maintain, it is better for you. So to summarize, there are both good and bad things for this year. It's a very significant and very supreme union that is happening. The union of not just the sun and the moon, but the sun and the earth. And use this year for advancing spiritually. Reduce all sorts of communication, observe Maunavrata, and try to do as many Kumbhaka Pranayama as possible. I once again wish you all a very happy and a prosperous Ugadi. Thank you very much.